So probably one of the longest struggles that I've had to go through through my young adult years all the way into my adult years is anxiety and people pleasing. And it's funny because if people learn that about me, usually they say I don't look it. But doesn't mean it still doesn't show up in my life occasionally. Just yesterday I had to deal with it, probably more than I have in the past couple months or so. And it was triggered by something that kind of made me feel, it made me feel a little awkward, because it was a situation where I had met somebody on Instagram. We had, had some, it was another artist. We had kind of talked back and forth a little bit, but we had never met this person in person for the first time. And it was just like, they didn't remember the conversation we had, which is totally cool. Like it wasn't a big deal on the surface, but it's just one of those things that for me, I was going to an unfamiliar environment, didn't know anybody, So I was trying to build new connections with people. And the one connection, I thought I could, kind of bridge and make, just kind of turned awkward real quick. I mean, it was literally like a, 1 to 2 second, which feels like an eternity, like moment of silence, trying to find something to talk about, looking around or whatever. So it was fun. Fun experience, and that kind of failed interaction, I guess. It just led me to want to make this video, because I was doing a little bit of closure time this morning, and just encourage you and even myself that you don't have to prove anything to people, and you are not people's expectations of you. And I notice a lot of times we wear the weight of people's expectations, we wear the weight of our own expectations, and they become the defining voice in that moment. And I want to tell you too, like it's a habit, it's a practice to really overcome those types of thoughts. Because I don't feel like that all the time, but there's occasions when there's something that is important to me that I wasn't expecting. If I get let down in it, it can kind of resurface a lot of old feelings and old patterns of thinking. And so be kind to yourself through the process, but I did want to give one just piece of advice, kind of a practical piece of advice to help during those times. One thing that I found really helpful is when you take the focus off of yourself and give yourself the permission to really serve someone. Because I tell you what, it's something about getting outside of yourself and giving to someone else that helps you get your mind off of yourself. Because a lot of times when we're going through those anxiety and people-pleasing moments, usually it's because we're kind of wrapped up in ourselves, our egos. Like our thoughts are really consumed about us and how we look towards a person. And when we take a minute to transport our mind off of the situation that we're going through and say, you know what, I'm gonna go do something for someone else because I'm trying to do so much for me in this current situation, which is understandable, but sometimes those thoughts become very, almost like self-indulgence, you know what I mean? And so I've just noticed at times when I'm like, you know what, I'm just pivot my thinking just in this moment and say, is there someone or some way I can serve another human being? And you'll start to see some of those feelings decrease and minimize a lot. Another trick I do sometimes is writing down that particular emotion and just giving myself the permission to just get it out, you know what I mean? Like maybe I'm not at a place where I want to talk about it with somebody. I'll just write it down and just say, you know what, I got it out, let's keep moving. And even within that, I might write the thing that I was anxious or frustrated about or whatever, but then I'll also write the opposite of it, something that's producing gratitude in me, finding something to latch on to get my mind state framed back into a thinking of gratitude. And so there's little tricks that kind of help me in some of those times. I wanted to share that might be helpful for you. And I'll probably try to do more of this stuff just as I get you know, things that I feel like might be helpful for people in that same place. But I didn't want to make this long. I just had that, and I feel like I just wanted to get it out for you guys real quick while I was fresh. So let me know if this was helpful at all, if you use any of these tactics. Let me know if they work for you. I know dealing with it, you know, can be tough at times. It's a beast. It's annoying. but, you know, it helps us to grow. It teaches us endurance. And a lot of times it's probably not as big as we make it out to be. And I share this stuff because I love you guys, and I know there's other people who deal with that kind of mental stuff. So that's all, y'all. I love you guys. Go check out the Patreon. I got some really cool exclusive stuff on there. And your support means the world. I thank you for everybody who's already been supporting me. But that's it. Peace.